Yes. Subtract the section modulus of this whole. So minus t into dp square. Maybe you can take t or t also out. So 1/6 of t b1 square minus t dp square. So t dp square is this here reduced from this whole section. So we have derived, we have worked out the equation for section modulus for this particular section. So having done this much, now you will find in this equation what are the things not known. You will see that only this is not known, only b1 is not known. So you can find out how much is b1 you require. So when you subtract this, you require to increase the size compared to this b. So this you will get some value of b1 which is higher than what you expect here at b. So once you do that, what this is going to do is, at this place the section is going to look like this. So this is dp and this is b1 and this is b. So the shape of the lever will be modified here so that this b1 will be more like this. Same thing if you want to show here, it will be like this. So we have increased b to b1 as per this equation by considering that there is a pinhole, so that the cross section is still as strong as it wants, even though there is a hole that is cut here. Okay, so this way you can cut one hole, increase the cross section to make it suitable for taking the bending stress, and now this part is ready up to this much. Okay, now what is next? Next is we have to do something similar here. What is going to be the cross section here? We have changed b to b1. Are we going to change b to something else here also? The answer is no, because if you remember the way bending moment diagram was drawn earlier, according to that the bending moment is maximum here, it is zero here, and it is zero here. So at this place there is no bending moment acting. That means here, this kind of equations are not required. But then that doesn't mean that the size of the pin is zero. The moment is zero, so pin size is zero. That doesn't happen. We should have some such size. So here, as far as the standardization principle, what we have learned earlier, according to that, the we are going to provide one bracket here, and to that bracket there will be going to be a pin. That pin we are going to take of the dimension same as this pin, so that both the pins will be of same size. So when you want to keep space, you don't have to keep two different sizes of pins. So one size of pin, quantity two, is sufficient. One will be used here, one will be used here, and maybe few more extra which can be used here also or here also anytime in future when there is a breakdown. So that is why we are using same size of pin here, where actually the moment is going to be zero. So it is still safe to use a pin which is used here same as here. Okay, so now the next thing is you have to design this particular bracket and also the wall bracket and this. So at the moment we have designed the lever, we have decided the cross section, we have designed the revised cross section, we have also decided the pinhole here and here. So as such the lever dimensions are complete. So at this stage the work is over as far as only lever is concerned. But we are taking this as an exercise, as a system design. System design means that means the whole system you are going to design. We are asked to do the whole work of all the parts that are involved. Every part we are supposed to design in this exercise. So out of that lever is designed. Now we are going to design this lever bracket, this fulcrum bracket, and this arrangement. That also we are going to design. But while doing that, we are not going into a lot of details. We are just making use of some simple rules and proportions, which also you will be able to understand and learn how it is done. Let's see. So the next is design of fulcrum bracket. Design of this fulcrum bracket. So what we do here is we bring into picture the lever, cross section, which is already decided as B by T. Now here we are continuing with B because we know there is no moment acting here, so there is not going to be a question of the section model is becoming weak because of this pinhole, so no problem, we can continue with B. And after that we draw the bracket like this. And then we put one pin, which is same as last time. Okay, so this is a fulcrum pin. This is at fulcrum. So I am drawing the section of a fulcrum bracket. So what bracket you are going to use, what we have seen shown here as a symbol, this is the actual bracket going to be. Okay, now this has to be designed, means you have to finalize its dimensions. So if you see the top view of this bracket, the top view of the bracket will come something like this. Then there will be two such plates here, and then there is a pinhole, and then there is a lever inside. Okay, so I have just drawn the top view, and then now we are going to decide the different dimensions so that this can be made. There could be holes here for fixing the bracket to the base. So you can see here there are holes so that this bracket can be fixed. Now what are the different dimensions and how are you going to set, finalize those dimensions without going into the lot of details of the stresses, etc. So one thing is, since the thickness here is T, and that thickness we have already decided by the bending stress, at the moment what you can assume is this thickness T is sufficient for the work. In fact, what you can do by going back where the lever was designed, maybe you can check the thickness T for the stresses, for the bearing stresses. I'll maybe write here to check, because that was not done earlier, to check the pinhole for bearing stress. So to the lever, whatever hole was created here, diameter DP, whether it is safe for bearing stress, that is to be checked, which we have not done earlier, you can do now, which you can write at the time of writing, you can write there. So you can say that bearing induced is equal to load upon area, load is F, and what is the projected area here? DP into T. You know this is the projected area. So since everything is known, you can find out how much is the induced stress, and this induced stress should be less than the design stress. If this is so, then safe. If it is less, that means bearing stress is less than limit and this will not be a problem. Okay. And what happens if there is a problem? Then you have to increase this area. So if you increase DP, there will be a problem. There will be difficulty, because if you increase DP, the earlier bending stress will be a problem. Then maybe you have to again increase the B. So instead of that, you can increase T, and you can maybe, if you require, you can add some thickness here like this. That means DP is this. That means you have increased the thickness. This rest of the thickness is T, but around the hole the thickness is T1. So you can increase it to T1 if required, if this is not safe. Otherwise you can continue with T. So if this fails, you are increasing T also to T1, and if it fails in the bending, which will be, so we have increased B also to B1. So it will be either B1 and T1 both, or it will be only B1 and T can continue. So whatever is the case, accordingly this is final, either T or T1, where the bracket is going to be. In fact, this will be all required here. At this place we can still continue with T. This I am talking about maybe the case here. So here what will happen is, since T is alright, then that means for bearing stress this is sufficient. So this can be taken as T by 2 and T by 2. Because the load taken here is, suppose R, then the load here is R by 2, R by 2. Obviously it is half of. Total load here is R. So this is equally divided because it is symmetric. So for half load, the thickness also can be half. So if this is T, this, you can take this at T1 by 2. Now what will be taken here? For standardization, we'll take this also T1 by 2. You know, we are not thinking of lot of failure, etc. So for proportions, for simplicity, we are doing this just considering simplicity, assuming that nothing will fail. Okay. Now how you will make it? For making this, by taking same sizes, it becomes easy to make here, because you can join these two plates. So by making use of three plates, this is one plate. To that one plate, you are welding two more plates here. So this is one plate, base plate, same thickness T1. So you take one plate of thickness T1, cut into pieces, one piece of this size, and then two more pieces of this size, and weld them here, and the bracket will be formed. And when you do that, you are going to cut one hole here on this bracket. So see, the whole bracket will look something like this. So these two plates we are going to weld here. Back side also. And now you require to know this distance. And what distance you require to put this hole. That is going to be, since this is B, this is going to be half of B. B by 2 plus some clearance. So I'll write here B by 2 plus 5 to 6 mm. Or 2, 3, 4, 5, some clearance. So that is the distance where you are going to cut this hole. The size of the hole is DP. The size of the hole is going to be DP. So you have cut holes like this. Now what are you going to do here? You are going to put some holes so that you can fit the screws. So for screw, maybe you can assume whatever is the sizes are coming. According to that, suppose this comes in certain range, accordingly you can decide maybe 6 mm or something. So you can make these holes of size maybe 6 mm. Just I am taking example, you can change this. So for a 6 mm hole, when you are going to put the nut, then the head of the nut, you should be able to accommodate here. So it should not happen that the head of the nut is foul here. So it should not touch here. So for 6 mm threading, the hexagonal across corner is 12 mm, so you can keep this as 15 mm. So both sides 15 mm, and here also you can keep some clearance as 1 mm, both sides. So you have got T, 1 mm, 1 mm, T2, T2, then 15 mm, 15 mm. So if you add all these things, you will be able to find out what is going to be your one size, one dimension of the plate. Thickness is already decided. Now this width depends on this length, and this length depends on diameter of the pin plus something extra. Now again, no criteria, you can select some suitable distance. So if size of the hole is D, a 6 mm is the bolt size, maybe you have 6 mm, 6 mm here and few more here. So maybe this could be 4 times or maybe 5 times 6. If 6, 7 is the size of the hole, then 5 to 6 times the size of the hole you can make this. Just an approximation which will work. So, and then some height, remaining height, height above this. Rather not here, here. We are talking about the bracket. How much bracket should be above? So again, that is left to you to decide. As we said earlier, certain dimensions are not having any criteria to decide. So any suitable size you can decide. Only thing is this DP should be accommodated there. And plus some extra space, some clearance. It shouldn't happen that the hole is opening from here. So some extra margin. So that will be this size. So now all the dimensions of this bracket are final. And we have designed one more component, that is bracket. So we have earlier designed this lever, considering all proper stresses, everything. And for designing bracket, we have taken into account only proportions, suitable proportions, and some standard sizes that are available, and some common sense, everything, whatever is there. According to that, we have finalized the size for the bracket, and bracket is also designed. We are talking about system design. So having done this, next thing is bracket for the wall, how this wall is to be made. So again, by similar criteria, we will think about how this wall arrangement is to be made. So the next is design of wall bracket. Design of wall bracket. Now at this place you can think of the arrangement something similar to what is done here. So maybe I'll just draw how it could be. One thing is, this will be your lever that has got a hole. Now this dimension is B1. Okay. Last time we have seen why it is so. Okay, so we are talking about this lever bracket at this place. You can draw with proper cross section, everything, section lines, etc. Like this. Then there is a bracket here. You can show welding here. So what is done here is, this bracket is made something similar to what we have done here. So there is one base plate. Two more plates here, some clearance, bolt is there, DP is a pin diameter. This is B1 this time, because here it is at this place where the width is B1. And then the base plate is different from what is done here. Here the base plate was having some fittings with the help of some bolts you are going to fit it to the frame. Here that is not the case, but here to this plate we are going to fit the wall. So the wall is shown like this, conical shape, some diameter here, some threading here. So this threading is used for fixing this particular part. So instead of making this whole thing as one piece, because that will be very costly to make, if you would show this as a single piece, then cutting from a solid block of this shape, it will be very very costly operation. Instead of that, you can make use of three plates, fit them like this, and then with a tapping here, you can fit it like this, so that this entire bracket is prepared. And what dimensions you want here, those dimensions similar to what we have done last time, you can find out all the different dimensions just by proportion. Now this size is given, cross section area is given. Cross section area is given in the exercise, or maybe diameter is given. So this size is final, because on this diameter the pressure is applied and you get the force. So only this dimension is there. Accordingly you can decide some suitable dimension. Maybe you can take this angle as 60 degrees and then some suitable thickness, any such diameter of your choice, suitable size, some suitable threading, and all these things you decide yourself and finalize this shape. Not very important from the stresses point of view. Okay, only what you do is the thickness what you get here, we already seen thickness is T, so this is going to be T by 2. Okay, if you increase the T, accordingly this will change, but this will be half and some clearance everything. So this could be the way you can finalize the bracket at the wall. So wall bracket is also final. Now this is remaining, the arrangement for putting weights. Now what you will do here for putting weights, if you think of this end of the bracket, you can see that the end of the bracket is like this. And here, this is, I drawn the end, somewhere at a distance L2, you are going to attach the weights. Now for attaching the weights, as you know, you must have seen how the weights are attached. There is normally a bracket like this. And then here, there is a stand like this. And then there are weights. Now these weights look like this. So these weights you are putting here on this hanger. So this is a weight hanger. This is called as weight hanger. So you have to design this weight hanger. How you will design the weight hanger? What you will do is, we already know how much is the weight you require. So you know the weight required. So whatever you are going to attach here, that will be equal to the weight of all these things will be equal to W. So whatever you decide, how many things you are going to put. Maybe you can now see here, there are, as I said earlier, sometimes the design which is there, I am talking about the actual design in practice, outside institute when you go, the real day life design. So that time there are a lot of variables around you. So the problem is not fully defined. So here, let us get some experience of that. So here we are asked to design these weights and the hanger. You are given only the final size W. You want to apply total weight as W with some variations possible, but how to do it, it is left to you.